8, 5 or 9 on this one. And he just did a, you know, number of searing re-entries and cutbacks. And it was a real strong opening ride, and a lot of events, people tend to hold back on their first ride and take it easy, but Tom went all out on this first one here. You know, as in surfing competitions, the length of the ride determines the score, so you'll see Tom surfing right to the shore. This is Barton Lynch up on his first ride. Barton's also from Sydney, and he's a goofy footer the same as Tom. This wasn't quite as good a wave as Tom's first wave. The wave's foamy and it didn't have as much clean face on it, and it didn't allow him to do as many radical manoeuvres off the top of the wave, which are the high scorers. This was Tom's second ride in the final. He chose to go right on this wave. That's one of the strong points of Tom's surfing, is that vertical manoeuvre that he does on the top of the wave, and it's a very high-risk manoeuvre. It's a hard manoeuvre to do, and it's quite easy to fall off on it, so you've got to be very confident to go for those manoeuvres and pull them off. It sort of slips off the tail there. Here's Barton up on his second wave here. Barton did a great re-entry on that one, recovering from that, and unfortunately slips on that one. Very hard to do a re-entry when the wave totally closes out. It's hard to sort of stay on. This is Tom's third wave. Tom just got better and better as the final went along. His surfing became more and more positive wave after wave. And as the final progressed, he continued to increase his lead. You'll see him working this wave over in the white water, all the way to the sand. That last part of the wave is very crucial, to do a lot of little turns, because that adds to your score. But so the way the waves are breaking, like with these lefts here, they were perfect waves for Tom and also for Barton. And it was the best surf of the whole week for the contest. The surf improved all the way through. Tom made a great recovery there. He did a radical cutback and nearly slipped off and managed to get back on again. As I was saying, the surf improved all the way through, and it climaxed with perfect surf for the final. Uncharacteristically, in this final, Barton Lynch fell off on about 3 or 4 waves, and that sort of seriously hampered his chances. Tom didn't fall off on any at all and was looking very strong all the way through.
They've produced some great Olympic swimmers in the past, the Japanese, Mark. What about the surfing scene? Have they got any champs of the future?
They've got some really good surfers. A guy by the name of Sakino came 5th in the event, and he knocked out Sean Thompson, who was rated 2nd in the world going into the event. So the standard of surfing each year you go over there is improving. Each year there's more and more contenders. I think that when we first started going to Japan, if you had a Japanese guy in your heat, you didn't have to try too hard. They were pretty easy to beat. These days you've got to pull out all the stops, because they are very hard to beat. The water was quite cold there. The weather was nice. It was nice and sunny, but you'll see both guys are wearing wetsuits because the water was very cold. And also there are a lot of blue bottles in the water. There were a couple of days there where there were thousands of them, and it was nearly impossible to paddle around or to ride waves without getting stung. This was Tom's last wave in the final. He caught that wave with about 2 or 3 seconds to go. Just